Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how you can select a value in one drop-down box and have the values in another drop-down box be displayed based on what was chosen by the user in the first drop-down box. And to give you a visual of what we mean by this, we have a drop-down box here where the user can pick international or domestic, and this drop-down here will populate based on what was picked here in E2. So if I pick international, I'm getting all the international cities. And if I click domestic and go here, I'm getting all the domestic cities.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So the first thing I want to do on this spreadsheet is I want to go into cell E2 and I want to give my user a choice between international and domestic. So if I click in E2 and I go up to data and I go over here to data validation, I'm going to click this dropdown right here and pick list. And then under the source, I'm going to click this up arrow and just highlight the two cells where I have international and domestic. Click this arrow again and say okay. And now I can see that this dropdown allows the user to pick between international or domestic. Next, I'm going to click here in E5, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to go up to data, and I'm going to go over here to data validation, and I'm going to choose list. But instead of selecting a list here, I'm going to click where it says source, and I'm going to type a formula. So I'm going to type equals if with a left parenthesis. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. And then I'm going to say, if E2, remember up here, E2 is where the selected cell is going to be, equals, and in double quotes, I'm going to type domestic and end my double quotes, and then type a comma. So if E2 equals domestic, how do I want to populate this dropdown? That is going to be from C2 with a colon to C8. And then I'm going to type a comma. And now this is my otherwise statement. So if I don't want domestic to be selected, I want international to be selected because that's the only other choice. And the international cities are found from B2 colon to B8. And then I'm going to close my parentheses and say okay. So if I go up here into E2 and I select international, and then I go down here into E5, I can see that the international cities are being populated in the dropdown. If I go back to E2 and I change that to domestic, I can now see that the cities in E5 are now my domestic cities. So we go into some other ways that you can do this out on our blog, and I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn some alternative ways of doing this. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.